to the NoHo Rag with Alec Reidel. Now, we got a hell of a show for you tonight with an exclusive investigative scoop that you're not going to want to miss out on. But before we get into that, let's talk about the news. Now, this past week, we had midterm elections here in the US of A, and as expected, everything went red. But perhaps the most intriguing story to come out of all that is this image right here of a man thumbing down incumbent Kentucky Senator Yertle the Turtle as he was voting. Now, unfortunately, we couldn't talk to the man afterwards because the Republican Party declared a fatwa on his head, dragged him from the polling place, and then filmed him as they set his legs on fire and decapitated him. Sorry, that was the Islamic State story. Apologies. No, because this is America, the world simply kept on turning, and that image just went viral. Hey, speaking of viral, you don't have to worry about that at all if you live in a country that doesn't believe in witch doctors and faith healers. No, the real story here is that internet sensation Tard the Grumpy Cat is getting her very own Lifetime original Christmas movie. And that's the punchline. Now, in world news, this weekend marks the 25th anniversary of the fall of the Berlin Wall, when the heroic United States of America finally triumphed over the evil Soviet bloc, and all was well with the world and peace was had by all. Or something like that. Now, in order to commemorate the man who's truly responsible for tearing down that wall, a wax figure of David Hasselhoff was erected in front of the Brandenburg Gate in Berlin, which just goes to show that you can have all the democracy and freedom that you want, but that's no accounting for good taste. Hey, speaking of washed-up celebrities, contrary to popular internet rumors, former child star Macaulay Culkin is still not dead. Speaking of things that won't die, the Islamic State is back in the news this week with its repressive ways. Key clerics have now declared that they will be closing down clinics where women could otherwise have safe abortions, and that they would be cutting coverage of contraceptives from their healthcare plan, while also trying to impose their specific religious doctrine in a region that has a multitude of different ethnic groups, all with their very own deeply held beliefs. Republican Party. But if you're looking for something a bit more lighthearted, why don't you skip on over to our Scoop of the Week? Now, as you may have heard, Taylor Swift had all of her music pulled from streaming services this past week, stating that music should not be free. Now, this may seem innocuous enough at first, but something piqued our interest here at the NoHo Rag. A group in Arizona calling themselves the Children of Swift saw their numbers swell in concurrence with this announcement. Now, naturally, this made me put on my investigative journalist cap to get the scoop that our viewers deserve. Now, the question on everyone's lips is, where's Taylor's music gone? Well, we here at the NoHo Rag have the exclusive interview that everyone's been waiting for. A new member of Taylor's house party, or some might say cult, has willingly brought himself over to tell us a thing or two about what's going on there. Joining us today, David.
No problem. Thanks for having me. This is great.
Oh, yeah. Any friend of Taylor's is a friend of ours. Now, I actually understand, though, that you're fairly new to the Taylor Swift fandom.
Yes, 3 weeks.
How exactly did you find out?
It was my ex, Stephanie. She was a huge Swift fan and bought an album, and we listened to it constantly. We would make love to it constantly. And before I knew it was a station on Pandora, I was on Spotify, I was waking up to it on iTunes in the morning. I mean, Taylor Swift, waking up to the glorious sounds of Taylor Swift in the morning is amazing.
What better way to start your day?
Yeah, and then...
it was gone. It was gone, and I was late to work, and I lost my job, and I just lost Stephanie. There was a message. There was a message in its place. And it said, meet us at the White Horse Ranch.
in Arizona. And I did.
We've heard of this. Admittedly, not too much actually comes out of the White Horse Ranch, but what exactly does go on there? They seem fairly secretive.
Oh, tons of activities.
There's Volleyball Mondays. There's the reading of Taylor Swift's on Sundays.
We play Mahjong. We play racquetball. Racquetball's fun.
We do sand drawings. The drawings are of her cats. We have to draw pictures of our cats. Those that aren't accepted are thrown into the big wind.
We do horseshoes. We do little horseshoe tournaments. And I have yet to win or make it past the first round.
I have faith in you. Sebastian! How did the NoHo star find out about this? This was supposed to be an exclusive interview.
Nothing's exclusive in NoHo, Alec. You should know this by now!
You've been poaching our interviewees since day one.
We've been working with this contact forever! David!
This ends today, Sebastian!
You're damn right, Alex!
No! So how exactly does one get into the White Horse Ranch?
It's real simple. I walked to the compound and was greeted with open arms and punch and soda and scones and...
Before I knew it, I was under extreme mental and physical challenges to test your true worthiness to Taylor Swift. And then they separated us into rooms, small groups. There were the cheers and the tears rooms. Thankfully, I got into one of the cheer rooms, and they were giving me a new clothes and a new name.
Oh, fantastic. Well, what was the new name?
The name's David.
So you went from David to David.
Yes.
David with a Y. It's all our names, they've changed the I's to Y's because Mother Swift doesn't want you ever asking why again.
Now, just out of curiosity, what exactly happens if you do ask why?
You get 17 lashes. It's actually... Taylor Swift's eyelashes are placed on your eyelids. You don't realize how heavy fake eyelashes are.
Just a world of black.
Just the darkness. Just the darkness as he's going around.
I asked why once, I'll never do it again.
But Mother Swift is very kind as she is punishing.
It's wonderful. That's all you want in a mother, right?
Yes.
Mother Swift is... the mother of all.
Well, it's been a fantastic time talking to you, David,
great
with a Y. Now, if you don't mind, put the case back on your head, get in the shed, and we'll take you out into the desert when the sun sets. Thank you so much. And that investigation is, of course, ongoing, so check back here for periodic updates. Well, that's it for our show tonight, folks. Thanks so much for sticking around. Hope you join us again next week. And remember, that upvote that you give just might be the cause of a terrible, terrible movie. Thank you all, and in case she's watching, hail Mother Swift.